Hi folks, the Filipina Pea here, and today I'm excited to share something unique and fascinating with you. Many of you have never heard of the Faroe Islands, an archipelago of 18 small islands located between Iceland and Norway in the North Atlantic. This society of rugged individuals only has around 50,000 people, but it's also made up of a surprising number of Filipinos. In fact, many of the Faroese men seek out Filipino wives who immigrate to the islands to adapt to a totally new lifestyle, climate, and culture. And today, I have the honor of actually reaching across the globe and speaking with one of its residents, who's been kind enough to grant us an interview and discuss this most unusual bond between the Philippines and his island home. So without further ado, let's say hello to Guli. Are you there, Guli?
Yes, I'm here.
Perfect. Hi. So am I pronouncing your name right?
Yeah, it's okay. It's Guli.
Guli. But the real name is?
Kutlaugur.
Kutlaugur.
Yeah, but hardly anybody uses that name.
Ah, okay. So you're speaking to us from the Faroe Islands, which is a self-governing territory, right? But you're part of Denmark.
Well, it's part of Denmark, but it's quite far away from Denmark.
Ah, I see. All right. Well, what language do you guys speak there? Is it like the old Norse language?
Actually, yes. It's only the Faroese people that speak my language. There are less than 100,000 people in the world that speak Faroese. Most Faroese people can speak Faroese, Danish, Norwegian, Swedish, and then German is also very similar, so a lot of Faroese people understand German too.
Oh. So,
and a little bit of Icelandic.
So you guys are Vikings?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that.
The Icelandic people kind of laugh at us because we're in between Norway and Iceland. So they say that there were the wimps that didn't dare to go all the way to Iceland.
I don't blame you. Anyway, Guli, can you tell us a little bit about yourself? You know, your age, your occupation.
Well, I'm 49, mm-hmm. and I work as a mechanic.
All right. Are you married?
No.
Are you looking?
No. I have a Filipino girlfriend.
Oh.
She doesn't live here yet.
Not yet. So, have you been here in the Philippines? Have you visited?
Yeah, I've been there three times.
Three times. So what's your first impression of the Philippines?
To be honest, when I first came there in 2017, I was thinking, okay, when I get there, I'll rent a car and then from the airport to the hotel in a taxi, I made up my mind. There's no way I'm going to drive in the Philippines. It's very crowded and loud, but it's a very beautiful and loving country.
So how did you know about the Philippines? Did you, is it because of your girlfriend or by the Philippines?
About 30 years ago, I started going to a church here in my town. And the preacher, he was Filipino. During the time I was going to that church in the 90s, they went to the Philippines once on an outreach. And I was supposed to go with them, but I couldn't afford it at the time. It made me get a connection with the Philippines.
So were you born in the Faroe Islands?
Yes, I kind of like lived here the whole entire life.
So do you travel off the islands a lot, or is it like the Philippines, like, you know, where people mostly just stay put in one location?
Since the 80s, people start traveling. We have an airline that travels three or four times a day,
mm-hmm.
from the Faroes to Denmark, or we got 10 different locations around the Europe where you have an airline connection.
So how would you describe life there? I know it's very modern. You know, fishing is the chief industry, right?
Fishing is 90% of the export. What's called salmon farming is a major industry. And then there is fishery. But here, it's usually the husband goes out fishing and is away the most part of the year. So it's similar in that way.
Wow. I mean, most part of the year? I mean, how often do they come home?
Well, some of them are home maybe, I don't know, less than a month within a year.
Wait, less than a month? Wow, it's a long trip. So I know that a lot of Filipinas end up going to the Faroes to marry the men there. Can you explain how that all started?
It started booming maybe 10 years ago. Before mm-hmm. that, there wasn't so many foreigners at all.
Okay. What do you think it's Filipinas? Are there like Thais, you know, other nationalities from Southeast Asian countries?
It's in the Faroes, there are about 500 people from Asia, and 360 of them are Filipinos.
Wow. Why? Why Filipinas? Do you guys just prefer Filipinas, or what is it about Filipinas?
Well, I can only speak for myself and from what impression I have. But I think it's because the Filipino woman remind us how things used to be. And maybe Western women are more demanding.
What do Faroese local women think of Filipinas? You know, invading Faroe Islands.
I don't think they really mind, because there are actually 2,000 more men than female in Faroe Islands. So, there are a lot of guys that are single because there are no women.
Okay, so there are a lot of single men and less women. So, okay, that's a match.
Yeah.
Do you personally know of many mixed couples there? You know, a Filipina and a Faroese.
Yeah, I have some friends that are married to a Filipino, but because my girlfriend is not living here yet, I'm not really into their group.
Mm-hmm.
I was invited to their Christmas party once, so I'm not a part of it, but I know some of their husbands.
How long have you been dating with your Filipino girlfriend, if you don't mind?
I started dating, writing with her in March of 2017.
2017, and since then you guys are in the long distance relationship.
Yeah, first it was just chatting, and then I went there that summer in July. It was a love at first sight.
Oh, love at first sight. That's nice. Did you guys meet online, or was it like you guys are introduced by a friend of friends?
No, it was online. I was in my mid 40s. I was looking for something, someone to share my life with. And I didn't see the possibility in getting a Faroese single woman
mm-hmm.
around my age. So I started thinking, and then I saw this page was Filipina Cupido or something like that.
Ah, okay, Filipina Cupid.
And okay. I just started looking, and then I realized if I had to chat to them, I had to pay. You had to be a member to be able to reply. So I thought, let's try 1 month. So I was chatting to maybe three or four of them, but this particular girl was something special.
How long till you know that she's the one?
Well, I only paid for this 1 month.
Okay.
Yeah, so then after maybe 2 or 3 weeks, we exchanged Facebook accounts and continue from there.
What? Are you planning to bring her there in the Faroe Islands, your Filipino girlfriend?
That's the plan, but unfortunately, she has been married.
Oh.
So that requires an annulment.
Ah, I see. Were you previously married or not?
No, I never been married.
Never been married. Okay. Yeah, that could be a challenge for...
Yes, but it's already 4 years since we started the process.
Oh, okay. So 4 years... So yes. she's been processing the annulment for 4 years. Wow,
if there wouldn't have been for the pandemic, mm-hmm. it would have been finished maybe more than a year ago.
Right, because everything
Of the lockdown, and then the hearing gets postponed, and it's the Filipino time. It's not like you come back next week. It's like 3 months.
I know. I understand. Is she excited, though, to go there once the annulment is done?
Yeah, she talks about it a lot.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, she can make friends of the Filipino people there, because, as you said, out of 500, there are 360 Filipinos there.
And if you compare it, we're only about 53,000 people in the whole country.
Yeah, I've seen
that. And that is like one third of the population of Domaghetti.
Yes, exactly.
And that would mean if there are 300 Filipinos, that would mean there would be 1,000 Faroese in Domaghetti. That's a lot.
In your opinion, Guli, when you see the mixed couples, you know, a Filipino and a Faroese, do you think their marriages last?
From what I've seen, the most of them, they last. Here in my town, I know about 50 maybe are Filipino girls that are married here. And, well, I don't know of any of them that didn't last.
Well, do you think they're based on love or on some other motive?
I think it's love, because I am a friend. I'm friend with a lot of them on Facebook, and I see they look happy. You know, they have their videoke nights, and among themselves, they are a really happy group, and their husbands, and they look happy.
Okay, so generally they are happy, and the Filipinas are happy with their new lives there, right?
Where it's quiet, and you can let your kids go out, and you don't have to worry, and we don't lock our house or car. Don't have to. It's safe.
Very safe. Virtually no crimes.
It's nothing serious. Murder is like two in the last 50 years. And
really? I could imagine, you know, living in a place that is so safe that I don't have to worry about locking my house. I think that's awesome. Do Filipinas have a hard time adapting to the culture and, you know, the country and the climate there?
The climate is a challenge, mostly, because when my Filipino says it's cold, it's like 20 degrees Celsius. and when it is extremely hot here during the summer, we maybe get to 20 degrees. It's more usually 15 or something like that during the summer.
And that's the hottest time of the year? 15 degrees? Oh, my God. I'll choose cold compared to being hot, because it's just, you can put more clothes anyway if it's cold.
Yeah, when it's getting hot, it's a limit how much clothes you can take off, because at one point there's no clothes left.
Do the Filipinos all stick together there? Do they have this, you know, little groups and communities?
Yeah, a lot of the Filipinos work in the fish factory. So those that work in that fish factory become friends, and you know, they stick together.
Oh, yeah. I've seen that also in one of the movies. Yeah, speaking of the movie, did you see the recent movie, Faraway Land?
Yes, I knew about it way before, because I saw pictures of them making it in the Faroe Islands. So I was very excited about it. It's okay movie, but I think it's too generalizing, both towards the Faroese husband and also the Filipinos that live here. It seemed like they wanted to portray the Filipinos like gold diggers, just wanted to get out of the Philippines and only cared about themselves. And the husband was there, a lucky guy. He was alone, a single, and he found love in a Filipino that somehow looks like he didn't get the love in return.
I know, and I feel so bad for the husband, because he was like treated horribly, and the movie made him look like a disposable bystander and made the Filipinos look like they had no conscience. It's misrepresentation of both cultures. I mean, for me personally, and for the other guy, you know, the other Filipino guy in the movie, 6 days and they're in love.
Yeah. It is, yeah.
Seriously? And do you know, do you remember that scene? You know, the apples fell on the ground. She was like grabbing them, and then the husband was just standing there. I don't think it is. Yeah, it's not really the reality of the, you know, the guys there, right?
No,
what do you think? No?
Far from.
I don't know what to make of that movie, but I was not really liking it. But also that scene when both, you know, the woman, the Filipino woman and the other Filipino guy, both of them sitting at the table with the husband and lying to his face, you know, when he came home from the fishing trip. Yeah. And it's like, oh my God, how could you sit down there and then in front of your husband after you just you know, slept with this guy. It was really bad. I mean, it's not really the accurate representation of Filipinas, I think. What did the Faroese people think of the movie? What do you think?
Well, I think most of the people are, you know, more proud of the surroundings in the movie. Mm-hmm. Because it portrays Faroe Islands as a very beautiful country.
It is.
The majority might maybe not know if the story is true or not. Like in like they said in the movie, I think a lot of people have that impression that we are buying the Filipinos online.
Mm-hmm.
Like the girls were talking in the fish factory. Where did you buy that girl? So that is also a part of the Faroese opinion about Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
You get it online and, you know, it's not love. A lot of people have that impression because at my work, some guys say, hey, you've been waiting 5 years. Why don't you just get a Faroese girl? They don't understand that you can love somebody and not be together. But I don't understand why they can't see that, because it's normal here. The woman's home, the husband's away most of the year fishing. Mm-hmm. So why can't I be here and visit her once a year in the Philippines and still be loved?
Where is your girlfriend from? Which part of the Philippines?
She's from Mabalacat. Clark.
Pampanga.
Yeah.
Pampanga. Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you cope with not seeing your girlfriend for 3 years in person, you know, not holding her? I'm sure you are so excited by now to come and see her. So how do you guys do it?
It's really, 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 really hard. But I just hang on to that hope. It's really hard also because her process of getting the annulment was supposed to be, okay, you get the answer in February.
Mm-hmm.
But then you don't get the answer before May or June.
Oh, my God.
And then there's supposed to be a hearing in October, but it doesn't happen until January. So it's always, you have this hope, no, it's going to be. Then, it has to wait. It has to wait. I can't remember if it was in May or early June. She got a message from the lawyer that the judge had granted her annulment. But she had to wait 2 or 3 months to get the paper. And that was in June.
Wow. So the last information she heard was it was granted, but she hasn't got the papers yet.
The paperwork had to be processed.
Were you helping her with the expenses for the annulment process?
I sent her the money for the process in October, 4 years ago.
May I know, if you don't mind my asking, how much you guys have spent so far for the annulment process?
I paid 250,000 pesos.
250,000 pesos. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that's for the process. But every time she goes to the court, she needs to pay another 2,500.
Yeah, so far for the annulment process, you've spent 250,000 for the annulment process. And every time she has to attend a hearing, she has to pay 2,500 pesos, like about $50. Yeah. Okay. Wow, and it's a lengthy process. Well, I wish you both the best. Hopefully it'll be processed soon. It's been 4 years.
Earlier this year, I was hoping, okay, Christmas, we're going to spend together. And now I'm kind of like doubting.
You know, for guys out there, for the guys that are watching this video, what advice can you give to them who are thinking of dating a Filipina?
Meet her in person, not just one day, but stay there, talk to her, be with her, because a person online can lie, but a person you're seeing for maybe 14 days, staying together, doing everything together, they can't keep lying. You will see if it's really, if it's real or not.
Yeah, guys, as what Guli said, meet the person, meet the Filipina in person, and at least make sure you love her, right?
First time I went there, I had this attitude. I'll go there, I'll meet her, see if I really like her. If I don't, well, I did get a vacation. So before going there, be prepared, have a hotel room or something. Don't expect to stay with her, because what if you find out I don't like her, and then you have nothing. You have a hotel room, fine. And that was kind of funny, because I was first time I went there, I didn't know about angels and mm-hmm. interpretation. So I got a hotel in Fields Avenue,
mm-hmm.
which is famous for loose women.
Yeah.
And she was a bit afraid of sleeping with me the first night, so she invited a friend. So I'm in a hotel room with two girls in Fields Avenue. That looks kind of creepy.
Two girls in your hotel room, yeah. Your hotel is in Angeles, yeah. You guys were there in the same room, sleeping?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Well,
it's just me, my girlfriend, and one of her friends in this hotel room. But already the first night, I met all her family, and it was confusing. Because the Faroe Islands, small, quiet, and mm-hmm. then you're there, 15 people in the same room, all living in the same house, and noisy. Everybody wants to talk to you. It was very confusing.
So, Guli, what do you see as the future of the Faroe Islands?
Well, we're in a financial boom. Our economy is really blooming. And employment rate is almost zero. So everyone has a work. And I see a very bright future.
Wow, that's great. And I hope some of my Filipina sisters will eventually go there. More Filipinas migrating.
They're welcome.
Well, that's great. Well, this has been fascinating, Guli, and I really appreciate your taking the time to introduce so many people to the Faroes. Your country is so lovely, and I hope to visit one day, hopefully. If I'm ever in your neck of the woods, I hope you'll invite me for some, you know, lobster or salmon.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you so much, Guli.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Bye. So that's it for today, folks. And I hope you enjoyed this very special episode where I brought you something you just won't see every day. I'll be back in just a few days with something else to surprise you. Till next time, folks. Bye.
If you think about it, I'm kind of like your stewardess, making sure you stay in an upright position during the video and guiding you to the exits. The exits of all your worries about life in the Philippines. The captain has asked that you please give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to this channel. And for your entertainment, we have a selection of other in-flight movies for you to enjoy. In the case of an emergency landing, place your head between your knees and kiss your ass goodbye. Have a nice flight!